Gentlemen, boys, and girls, welcome. I am Thomas Glenn with Lakes Area Community Television, and we are here at the Forest Lake High School Gymnasium for some extracurricular volleyball. That's right, Rangers postseason round one begins right now. The 2016 regular season, it doesn't matter. It's a thing of the past. A clean slate, a new beginning, starts with the beginning of match one here against Duluth Denfield. Serving for your Rangers, number nine, team captain Jamie Waters. Match one officially underway. And unfortunately, one bad hop, and the Hunters are on the board, leading 1-0 as they take over. Serving duties is number six, Ashley Larson for Duluth. Waters with the touch. Sent back over. Gronwig, now Waters. Trying to set up number 11, Liz Lee. Or I apologize, Kenzie Stumney, but I believe they're gonna call a net violation on the Rangers, and the Hunters take a 2-0 lead here in match number one. Larson with her second serve. Moscatelli has to get it over, and unfortunately, the top of the net not being so friendly to your Rangers here early in match one. The visitors go up 3-0. Larson making trouble for your Rangers. Waters, deflection, Duluth able to respond. Violation called on Duluth. Forest Lake will collect their first point and now only trail by two. Coach Alm not waiting long for her first substitution as number two, Eve DeSmet, checking in for your Rangers. That's gonna be trouble for Duluth. Forest Lake two, Duluth three. Just like that, that three-point lead now just down to one. Eve DeSmet with her second serve. Duluth with the response. Unfortunately, the Rangers unable to answer back. Duluth now leads by a score of 4-2 here in match number one. That's gonna send back number 10, Jordy Moss, to the line for Duluth. Serve is up, over, looks good. Play by DeSmet. And nice job by number 11, Kenzie Stumney. As she checks out, that's gonna bring in number 16, Clara, the Idaria Olson. And back to the line, number six, Ava Schmall for Forest Lake with her first serve. Contested, sent over, nice touch by Moscatelli. Duluth able to get it over on three. Gronwig with the kill. And the Hunters become the hunted. Forest Lake ties it up at four apiece. Let's see if Ava Schmall can give the Rangers their first lead here tonight. They did everything they could. That's just the way the ball drops. Forest Lake 4, Duluth 5. At the line for the Hunters, number 5, Caitlin Schnobis. And a changeup by number 16, Clara Olson. The Hunters expecting a fastball, and she decides to throw a breaking ball. Forest Lake playing mind games. Why not? It's the postseason. Back to the line for Forest Lake. Number 1, junior Ellie Capra. Duluth with the response. And the officials are going to say that stayed in. This game is tied at 5 apiece. On the line for the Hunters, number 3, Bella Larson. An unfortunate deflection from Gronwig will give it back to the Hunters, leading by 2. Larson with the serve. Forest Lake will send it back over. Bump, set, and touch. Nice job by Capper to keep it alive. Same on the other side of the net. Hunters send it over. Capper with the touch. Here comes Gronwig. What a nice touch by Gronwig. DeSmet will check out for Forest Lake. That's going to bring back number 3, Angela Denny, as Gronwig heads back to the line. Sent back over by the Hunters. Gronwig with the touch set up by Capra. Forest Lake able to send it over. Gronwig, Capra. And that's going to stay in. That is number 22, Sam Befke, for your Rangers. Forest Lake 7, Duluth Denfield 7. Gronwig back to the line, just a sophomore. Unbelievable the skills that that young lady possesses. Nice save. That is in. Nice. That is Angela Denny collecting the point there for Forest Lake, as the Rangers now take their first lead of the match. Gronwig, can she make it a 3-point run? Like I said, Abigail Gronwig, just a sophomore. We still have plenty to see from her. Capra. That is in, nice. Denny with the nice touch. That thing looked like it was heading straight out of bounds, and at the last second, dropped like a Burt Blyleven 12-6 curve. That was crazy. Gronwig, 3 points. Let's do 4. Serve is up, over. Nice job by the Rangers up front. Net violation called on Duluth, and Forest Lake now leads by 2. Let's go, number 12, make it 5. Gronwig with the serve. Sent back over by Duluth. Capra up front. Capra again. Now Denny. Nice attempt by number 3, Angela Denny, but the wall up front for Duluth. Excellent job blocking that. And Forest Lake just cannot respond. Now 10-8. Duluth trailing by 2. Back to the line. Number 11. Haley Larson. Excellent save by Denny. Sent back over by Befke. Gronwig with the response. And nice kill by Denny, having one hell of a performance here early in match number one. Forest Lake 11, Duluth 8. Back to the line for the Rangers. Number 16, Clara Idoubledaria Olson. Serve is up and over. Duluth with the response. Denny, amazing job by your Rangers. Wow. And play like that is going to force the opposition to take their first timeout here in match number one, as Duluth Denfield finds themselves trailing by 4 points. They had the lead early in the beginning. Well, I guess it's considered still the beginning, but I believe they had as much as a 5, maybe 6 point lead to start out match number one. Forest Lake has come back and reclaimed, or I guess just claimed the lead, first time they had it. But the important thing is they lead by 4. And like I said, they have forced the timeout taken by the opposition, which is a very good sign. Seems to be a very positive vibe here in the Forest Lake Gymnasium. I don't know. It just feels right. Junior 16, Clara Olson with the serve. Duluth with the point as that ball deflects off the top of the net and sails into the crowd. Forest Lake had no opportunity to respond. That's going to send back number two, Ellie Jackson to the line. Thank you, miscommunication. Point Forest Lake. They now lead 13-9. And it looks like we're going to have a couple substitutions courtesy Coach Alm. It looks like Waters will check back in, as well as number 8, Tia Moscatelli. Back to the line for Forest Lake. Number 9, Jamie Waters with the serve. Played by Duluth Denfield, sent back over. Nice save by number 6, Ava Schmall. Denny, who has been nothing but trouble for Duluth, racks up yet another point. Forest Lake 14, Duluth 9. Waters with the serve. Sent back over by number 2 of Duluth. Waters with the touch. Denny with the kill. Duluth able to respond. The Ranger wall proving trouble for Duluth. Denny. And that is number 8, Tia Moscatelli. That was not a kill. That was a statement with authority. Forest Lake now leading by 6. Waters, can she make it a 3-point run? Yeah, damn Skippy. Forest Lake 16, Duluth Denfield 9. Waters back to serve. Played by Denfield. They need to send it over, they do. Waters with the touch. Now Moscatelli. Well, that's just icing on the cake right there. Wow. See what the radar gun has on that. Like 97 miles an hour on that kill. Beautiful job by Moscatelli. Sent back over by Duluth. Nice job by Waters to keep it alive. And number 3, Angela Denny, is having an outstanding performance here for your Rangers, as they have forced the opposition to take yet another timeout as Duluth Denfield trails by 9. It's Forest Lake 18, the Hunters 9. You're watching Lakes Area Community Television. I am Thomas Glenn, the voice of your Forest Lake Rangers. Sectionals round one underway here at the Forest Lake High School Gymnasium, and this has been all Forest Lake here in match number one. Welcome back to more volleyball action here on Lakes Area Community Television. Number 9, Jamie Waters with the serve. And that is going to be interesting to watch in replay because I swear it went over the net. But at this level, we will not know, unfortunately. Duluth will benefit from that. Forest Lake with the touch. Moscatelli, unfortunately, misreads it. It's all right. Girls are still up by 7. Back to serve for the Hunters. Number 6, Ashley Larson. Denny. Wow. Another kill, and she has just become a serial killer. Checking back in for your Rangers, number 2, senior Eve DeSmet, as she will head right back to take over serving duties. Her squad up by 8 here in match number 1. And A for effort all the way around. That was a rocket. And now Duluth, trailing by 7, will take over serving responsibilities. Back to the line, number 10, Jordan Moss. Serve is up and over, played by Schmall. Now Waters, Gronwig looking for the kill. And the deflection alone, that's going to tell you how powerful that kill was by Gronwig. And like I said earlier, she is just a sophomore. So we have a lot more to see from number 12. Back to serve, number 6, Ava Schmall. Serve is up. And look at that. Olsen all over that. Forest Lake 21, Duluth 12, Schmall with the serve. That was like a knuckleball. And a nice touch by the Hunters, but sorry girls, that's out of bounds. Forest Lake 22, Duluth 12, Schmall with the serve. What a response by number 6, Ava the Flava Schmall, keeping the play alive. And that's number 16, Clara Olson. Wow. Rangers just 2 points away from closing out match number 1. Schmall's with the serve. Set. And an unfortunate deflection. We'll give it back to the Hunters, trailing by 10. Back to the serving line is number 5, Caitlin Schneewies. Forest Lake looking very sharp here in match number 1. DeSmet, Gronwig sends it back over, and miscommunication, yes. Ma'am, we will take full advantage of that. Forest Lake 24, Duluth 13, as Capra and Bethke check back in. Back to the line, number 1, junior Ellie Capra. Match point in progress. And Duluth Denfield finds a way to keep this match going. Still trailing by 10, match point. So this could be over just like that. Back to serve for the Hunters, number three, Bella Larson. Serve is up and over, played by DeSmet Capra. Thank you. And your Rangers take match number one by a score of 25-14. We're gonna switch sides. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Ranger Sectional Volleyball on Lakes Area Community Television. Match two coming up next.
They'll test you. Try to break your will. But however loud the loudness gets, however many cheese puffs may fly, you're the driver, the one in control. Stand firm. Just wait. And move only when you hear the click that says they're buckled in for the drive. Never give up till they buckle up.
Adventure can be found anywhere, but the best place to start is in the forest.
I spy something beginning with S.
Snow?
No.
Snow-covered trees?
Nothing to do with snow.
Head outside to discover incredible animals and beautiful plants that come together to create an unforgettable adventure.
Wow.
So grab your loved ones.
Don't even.
And explore a world of possibilities.
Come on, this way.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find the closest forest or park to you.
Welcome back to the one and only Lakes Area Community Television, where you're watching Ranger Sectional Volleyball. 2016 match number two, shortly underway. Forest Lake hosting Duluth Denfield. The Rangers winning match number one by a score of 25-14. Forest Lake actually began match number one trailing by as many as five or six, came back, and they never looked back. It has been all Rangers since then, and they look to carry that into match two that has officially began. And the Rangers are on the board with a 1-0 lead. Right off the bat, number three, Angela Denny checking out. That's gonna bring in number two, Eve DeSmet, as she will head back to the line to take over serving duties. Nice heads up play by number eight, Moscatelli. And Gronwig, need I say more? Forest Lake two, Duluth Denfield zero. DeSmet back to serve, looking for a 2-point run. It's gonna happen. Duluth with the response. They need to get it over here. And the Ranger wall gets a piece of it, but it was enough to deflect the ball into no man's land as the Hunters will take over. Serving responsibilities, trailing 2-1. Back to serve is number six, Ashley Larson. Played by DeSmet. Waters to Gronwig. Man, she is scary good. Checking in for Forest Lake, Clara Olson. And look at that, wow. Number six, Ava Schmall. Another very talented young lady. And that serve skims right off the top of the net and falls in for a point. Speaking of, Forest Lake five, Duluth one. A Little miscalculation there by Schmall. It's all right. No harm, no foul. Forest Lake still up by three. Duluth will take over serving. Number 10, Jordan Moss. Bronwig with the response. Waters sends it back over. And that's going to be trouble as Duluth runs out of real estate. Forest Lake 6, Duluth 2. Checking back in for your Rangers, number 1, Ellie Capra, and number 22, Sam Bethke. Capra will head back to the line for your Rangers. Seems to be one of the fan favorites here in Forest Lake. Serve is up and over. Nice job by DeSmet to keep it alive. Sent back over. Another nice job. Wow, Grunwig gets it over. And the Hunters get caught up in the net. The Hunters were trapped. Forest Lake 7, Duluth Denfield 2, Capra back to serve. And it's a breaking ball that completely throws off Duluth. They are able to recover. But not that time. Another heads up play by number 16, Clara Olson. Rangers leading by 6. Capra looking for a 3-point run. Point, Rangers. Timeout taken yet again by the opposition as they have no other options. Trailing by 7 here early in match number 2. And it's not just that, they feel it just like I do, and I'm sure most of you at home do as well. There is a vibe in this gym. You can see it on the face of all the Rangers. They just, I don't know, they know they're gonna win. You can see the confidence on their faces. Duluth, they are struggling with communication. They don't look focused. They're not having fun. I don't see a smile on a single face when I look in that huddle. When you look over at the Rangers, they're having a blast. And that's what you're supposed to do. High school sports, postseason. I mean, not everybody gets to be a part of this. It's truly something special. And with a 7-point lead, Capra with the serve. Ah, nice job up front. Just takes an unfortunate hop that will give it back to Duluth as number 5, excuse me, for the Hunters, Caitlin Schneweis with the serve, played by DeSmet. And then to Capra, and ultimately to Grunwig. And that goes off of the fingertips and back over. Duluth now trailing by 5. Schneweis with the serve. And it looked like almost a last second response by DeSmet. I don't think she originally planned on going for it. But not a problem. Forest Lake trailing by, up by 4. Schneweis with the serve. Played by DeSmet. Olson with the touch. And Duluth Denfield needs to get it over. They do. Capra. Grunwig. And that takes another Hunter hop. As Duluth Denfield has made that 7-point lead a 3-point lead. Played by Schmall, Grunwig sent back over by Bethke. Capra keeping it alive. Nice touch by, I believe. Oh, it was Bethke, not Olson. It was number 22, Sam Bethke, That's going to put the ball back in the Rangers' hands, up by four. Number 12, Abigail Gronwig, back to serve for the Rangers. Serve is up and over. It's going to be trouble up front. Nice job by Denny. And that's another Ranger point. Forest Lake 11, Duluth 6. Gronwig with the serve. Contested by the Hunters. And they find prime real estate along the near side on the Rangers. And the Hunters now trail by four as they take over serving. Number three, Bella Larson, played by Denny, Capra, and now Gronwig. Sent back over, touched by Denny. Now Capra back to Denny. Trouble up front, and 16, Clara Olson all over it. Stumney will check back in as Schmall will check out. Olson, maybe a little miscalculation. That's not like her. Forest Lake still leads by four. I have no idea how that ball even made it over the net. Like physics would break, or wait. Maybe, I don't know, I guess we don't, well. Never mind, point Forest Lake. Rangers lead 13-8. Back to serve, number nine, Jamie Waters. Serve is up, that's gonna be trouble. And the Rangers now take a 6-point lead here in match number two. Waters back to serve. Played by the Hunters. An amazing job by Waters and Schmall to keep the play alive. In the end, it's Duluth collecting the point, but an A for effort. That's just amazing. Lauren Hotchel back to serve for the Hunters. Last touch by Schmall, and now Moscatelli sent back over. Schmall with the touch to Waters. Denny with the kill. And she is on fire tonight. Wow. Forest Lake 15, Duluth Denfield 9. Denny will take a seat as number two. Eve DeSmet will check back in. And immediately take over serving. That is going to be trouble for Duluth. Somehow they find a response, but it doesn't matter. That is number 12, Abigail Gronwig. Forest Lake now with a 7-point lead. DeSmet back to serve. Up and over, played by the Hunters. And you gotta give her credit. Number six, Ava Schmall. Ranger, 6-point lead. Nice save by Schmall. Nice touch by Moscatelli. Kill attempt, that is saved by DeSmet. Gronwig, wow! The velocity on that. That thing had some English on it. Back to serve, her squad up by seven is number six. Ava Schmall, and booyah! Rangers now with an 8-point lead. Same thing with Ava Schmall. I don't know what it is, but the rotation that she gets on her serves are crazy. Watch this. That is an ace, my friend. And a 9-point Ranger lead. And that is going to give the Hunters no option but to resort to yet another timeout as match two has become all Forest Lake. And I think we are going to take a quick pause for station identification, but don't go anywhere. Match two coming up. Welcome back to the Forest Lake High School Gymnasium. You're watching Rangers Volleyball here on Lakes Area Community Television. I am Thomas Glenn. And I am also amazed by how well your Rangers are playing here tonight. Number six, Ava Schmall with the serve. And Rangers are going to run out of real estate there. Forest Lake winning match number one by a score of 25-14. Currently we sit here in match number two, Rangers with a 7-point lead. Gronwig contested by the Hunters. And that takes a Hunter deflection. Point awarded to Duluth. Forest Lake leading by six as number 16, Clara Olson will check out. And number 14, well that's not Tia Moscatelli. Okay, I'm trying to play catch up here. Waters just checked out, Moscatelli checked out, Capra is in. Serve is up and just skims off the top of the net. Sometimes she goes over, sometimes she doesn't. That time she did not. And Duluth will take over serving, trailing by six. Serve is up and over, played by number two, DeSmet. Oh, wow, Abigail Gronwig. Another huge heads-up play. Number three, Angela Denny checking back in as DeSmet will take a seat. Gronwig back to serve. And it's the top of the net. Can't we just get rid of that thing? Who says we need the top of the net? Forest Lake 21, Duluth Denfield 15. Played by Schmall. Capra and now Denny. Nice save by Gronwig. Capra with the touch back to Gronwig. Now Duluth up front. Nice save by Ellie Capra. Schmall sends it back over. Played by the Hunters. And although an amazing dive by Schmall, unable to get everything she wanted to on it. The ball will be sent back to Duluth. They now trail by five. Schmall with the touch. That's 22. Bethke sending it back over. And that is going to be awarded to the Hunters. I could see that one going either or. And now it is Forest Lake and Coach Alm calling a timeout as they have found themselves, well, back within 4 points. The Rangers 21, the Hunters 17. Whew. It's getting interesting, but we don't want to see it get too interesting. Forest Lake needs to come out of this timeout with the same level of energy and confidence that they had in the beginning of this match and throughout the entire first match. You can see the confidence slowly beginning to grow on the opposition, and we do not want that fire to get out of control. Trailing by four here in match number two, Luke Denfield back to serve. Sent back over by number 22, Sam Bethke. And that is over the line. Forest Lake 22, Duluth 17. Ranger substitution in progress, checking in for Forest Lake, making her 2016 sectional debut, number four, Emily Grindall. Serve is up, played by the Hunters. Nice save by Grindall. But just in that nasty net area, Forest Lake unable to get it over. Duluth back to serve, trailing by four. And again, just poor placement will put Duluth back within three. Haley Larson back to serve for the Hunters. Capra. Again, Ellie Capra, played by Grindall. Denny sends it back over. Capra with the touch. Angela Denny. Duluth with the response. Not that time. Rangers 23, Hunters 19. Substitutions in progress. Checking back in, number 8, Tia Moscatelli, and number 9, Jamie Waters. Waters will head the line. And she has served it up. Somehow, some way, that ball stays in. And Duluth will collect the point. Back to the line for the Hunters, number two, Lauren Hutchell. Serve is up and over, played by Gronwick, Waters, and Denny. Wow. That is what I call painting the corner. Wow. Match point, Forest Lake 24, Duluth 20. Eve DeSmet with the serve. Sent back over, played by Grindall, Waters, and Gronwig. And your Rangers win match two and go up 2-0 over the visiting Duluth Denfield Hunters. Wow. Don't go anywhere. We've got more volleyball action coming here from the Forest Lake High School gymnasium. Nice.
Patriotism. There's a word thrown around a lot. It inspires passionate debate and is worn like a badge of honor, and with good reason, because it means love and devotion for one's country. Love. For a word designed to unite, it can also be pretty divisive. You see, there's more to patriotism than flag sequins, onesies, and rodeos, and quadruple cheeseburgers. Patriotism is love for a country, not just pride in it. But what really makes up this country of ours? What is it we love? It's more than just a huge rock full of animals like cougars and eagles, right? It's the people. Do me a favor. Close your eyes for a second. I want to try something out. Picture the average U.S. citizen. Think about it. How old are they? What's their hair like? How much can they bench? You got one? Okay. So chances are, the person you're picturing right now looks a little different to the real average American. There are 319 million U.S. citizens. 51% are female. So first off, the average American is a woman. Cool, huh? Is that what you pictured? 54 million are Latino, 40 million senior citizens, 27 million are disabled, 18 million are Asian. That's more people in the U.S. than play football and baseball combined. 9 million are lesbian, gay, bi, transgender, more than the entire amount of people that live in the state of Virginia. Around 10 million are redhead, 5.1 million play ultimate frisbee, and 3.5 million are Muslim. Triple the number of people currently serving in the United States military. Almost half the country belongs to minority groups. People who are lesbian, African American, and bi, and transgender, and Native American, and proud of it. We know that labels don't devalue us, they help define us, keeping us dialed into our cultures and our beliefs and who we are as Americans. After all, what's more American than freedom to celebrate the things that make us, us? I mean, it's stitched into the stars and stripes of this country, from the Constitution to Gettysburg, to our motto, E Pluribus Unum, from many, one. It's even in our country's name, the United States. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, disability, sexuality, race, religion, and any other labels. Because the second any of us judge people based on those labels, we're not really being patriotic, are we? So let's try this one more time. Close your eyes. Picture the average Joe or Joan or Juan or Jean-Luc. The real people will make America, America. And this year, whenever you feel the urge to don those star-spangled shorts, set off fireworks the size of my biceps to show love for our country, remember that to love America is to love all Americans. Because love has no labels.
Back to Rangers Volleyball here on Lakes Area Community Television. Thomas Glenn sitting alongside me. My good cameraman, Brandon. Here on this beautiful Wednesday evening as your Forest Lake Rangers have taken a 2-match lead here in postseason volleyball. And if you're wondering what that weird sound is, those are the Tic Tacs that I still have in my mouth from break. Starting out the Rangers, number 9, Jamie Waters, and match number 3 officially underway. Misread possibly, looks like she may have slipped there. Duluth taking a 1-0 lead. An excellent save by Schmall. Sent back over and off the top of the net. Can't blame anybody for that. Duluth with a 2-0 lead here early in match number 3. Caitlin Schneewies back to serve. Played by Gronwig and now Denny. It's amazing that Duluth was able to recover from that. They do. Sent back over, played by Moscatelli, now Waters, Denny. And that takes a Hunter deflection. And Duluth is up 3-0 here in match number three. Schnuise with the serve. Played by Grunwig to Waters. And that is number 11, Kenzie Stumney, picking up points for Forest Lake as they are now on the board. Eve DeSmet back to serve for Forest Lake. And that is trouble for Duluth. Forest Lake 2, Duluth Denfield 3. DeSmet with the serve. Played by Duluth Denfield. Trouble sending it back over, a net violation. And that's going to result in another Ranger point. And just like that, they have tied this baby up. It's 3-3. DeSmet with the serve. Nice response by DeSmet. Sent back over. Quick touch by Duluth. Waters. And they are going to run out of real estate. Forest Lake now with the lead. An excellent job by Kenzie Stumney. Up front for Forest Lake. Serve off the top of the net. Sent back over, but that is out of play. And your Rangers now have a 2-point lead here in match number three. DeSmet, can she make it a 3-point run? Ball takes a bad hop. And that will go back to Duluth as they trail by one. Bella Larson back to serve for the Hunters. Waters with the touch. Moscatelli with the answer. Wait, what? So I guess they're going to call a net violation on the Rangers. That's going to tie this thing up at 5 apiece. But Grunwig is just going to get us the lead anyways. Forest Lake 6, Duluth Denfield 5. Back to serve for your Rangers, number 6, Ava Schmall. Having an outstanding night for her Rangers here. And what a job by number 8, Moscatelli, and 16, Clara Olson up front. Schmall back to serve. Another one of those funky rotation serves that she has in her arsenal. And that is number 12, Abigail Grunwig, putting it where they can't get to it. Forest Lake now with a 3-point lead. Schmall with the serve. Duluth with the response. But not as responsive as Forest Lake. That was beautiful, and they now lead by 4. And that's right. They've made the opposition take yet another timeout. Forest Lake leads 9-5. And I can walk away and spit out my Tic Tacs. Thank you. Welcome back to Lakes Area Community Television. Rangers volleyball in progress. Match number three is officially underway. Forest Lake winning match number one by a score of 25-14. They win match number two, 25-20. And look to do the same here in match number three. Wow. Now that is rotation as the ball literally rides the net halfway across the court and falls in for a Ranger point. DeSmet with the response, Waters, and now Moscatelli with the exclamation point, and the Rangers lead by six. Schmall with the serve. Duluth barely able to recover there. Wow. That thing was clocked at a good 85, 90 miles an hour. Rangers now with a 7-point lead, 12-5. Ava Schmall with the serve. And just caught the top of the net. And the Hunters, trailing by six, will take over serving number 11, Haley Larson. And she struggles with the serve. Checking back in for Forest Lake, number one, Ellie Capra, and number 22, Sam Bethke. Capra will head straight back to the line to take over serving, her team up by seven here in match number three, sectionals 2016. Sent back over by Bethke. Duluth up front. An amazing save by number six, Ava Schmall, and just like that, the Rangers will collect. As they now have an 8-point lead here on their home court. Capra back to serve. Up, takes a bad Hunter hop. Wow, an amazing save by Duluth Denfield. And an even better heads up play by your own number 16, Clara Olson. She is having an outstanding night for Forest Lake, and that will force Duluth to take yet another timeout here in match number three. This Ranger team, wow. When they are playing up to their full potential, I just don't know if there's anybody that can beat them. I mean, they have literally all the tools that you look for in a team as far as volleyball goes. I mean, it's just amazing. And when it's working on all levels, it truly is an amazing sight. Match number three, about to get back underway. Capra back to the line, ready to serve and close this thing out. Rangers lead 15-6. Nice job by number six, Ava Schmall. I believe they're gonna call that a push on DeSmet and credit the visitors with the point. Now 15-7. As number two, Lauren Hutchell, will head back to the line for Duluth Denfield. Serve is up and over, played by DeSmet. Gronwig with the kill. Rangers 16, Hunters 7. Checking out, Eve DeSmet. Checking in, Angela Denny. Also checking out is number 12, Abigail Gronwig, in exchange for number 13, Liz Lee. And before I forget, before the match even began, just a beautiful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner performed by Sophie Pointer of your very own Forest Lake Rangers. I mean, it was beautiful. Back to serve for the Hunters, Ashley Larson, played by Schmall. Now Capra, Liz Lee. Boom. Now checking in for Forest Lake number 4, Emily Grindall. And I believe Kenzie Stumney back in for Forest Lake. Rangers 17, Hunters 8. Grindall with the serve. Played by Duluth, sent back over. They did everything they could. It just one of those deflections that you cannot answer. Serve barely clears the net. Capra with the touch. And Stumney. Beautiful placement there. Moscatelli checking back in, and number 9, Jamie Waters, as she will head back to the serving line. Rangers 18, Hunters 9. Waters with the serve and hits the top of the net, falls in Ranger land, and will be given back to the Hunters, trailing by 8 here in match number 3. Serve is up, played by Grindall. Waters doing everything she can to keep it alive. The Rangers just run out of room. And Duluth will collect the point there as they now trail by 7. Schnuise with the serve. Stumney with the response. An amazing job on both sides of the net to keep this volley going. Angela Denny. Wow. That girl has got some power. Number 2, Eve DeSmet will check back in for Forest Lake. 8-point lead intact. DeSmet with the serve and almost catches. Well, I guess she did catch him off guard. And the Rangers now lead by 9. Forest Lake 20, Duluth Denfield 11. DeSmet with the serve. And an ace. Let's see if DeSmet can close it out. Nice save by DeSmet. Waters, and DeSmet sends it back over. Played by Duluth up front. That looked like a push to me. That's going to go uncalled. Good luck getting to that one. Rangers 22, Hunters 11. Checking back in, number 17, Emily Peterson DeSmet with the serve. This could be trouble up front. Nice save by DeSmet, sent back over. Duluth able to respond, and it looks like we have an injury on the court, and with the whistle, I think we're gonna go to commercial break. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Forest Lake High School Gymnasium Ranger Volleyball in Progress. Match 1 and 2, a thing of the past. Match 3, well, that's still going on. Forest Lake leading 22-12. As Duluth Denfield will make a couple substitutions before they take over serving duties. Back to serve number 3, Bella Larson. Waters up front. What an amazing heads up play. Rangers 23, Duluth Denfield 12, and this Forest Lake crowd, you can hear them. They have a message for the opposition. Match point for your Forest Lake Rangers here in the first round of sectionals. This baby has been all Forest Lake. Back to serve number 6, Ava Schmall. Played by the Hunters. Nice save by number 6, Schmall. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen, just like that. Match 1, 2, and 3 have all belonged to your Forest Lake Rangers. They live, and they live to fight another day. What an amazing performance all the way around. Congratulations to Coach Alm and her very talented group of young ladies. What a performance. Nice job, ladies. That's going to do it for us here from the Forest Lake High School Gymnasium. It is all Forest Lake Rangers, and they will send Duluth Denfield back home, literally empty-handed. Thanks for watching. This has been a production of Lakes Area Community Television.